Alright.
There we go. That should be all set up. So, it is time to start the campaign. Universal Studios needs help. Oh my god. Doc Brown's van. Power Wash Services. Want to get into the movie business with us at Universal Studios? You see, I'm a producer currently on location, looking at a dirty prop, and wishing I had a big old water pistol to wash it down with. When I said as much on set, my intern pointed out you in the phone book. I had no idea power washing was even a thing, but apparently people watch it for hours on their VHS. Who knew? Think you'd be up for coming down and helping us out? We loaned a medium-sized truck to another production. It's come back filthy as anything, and we need it for our next shot. Thanks a lot. Hello. Okay, there we go. All right, so we got... Should we just take off a little bit of stuff first?
The light, yeah. Light one.
Hey there, welcome to the set. I'm Alex. I'm a total whiz with a pager, so the producers have asked me to regular check in with you. You're excited to be in a movie set, aren't you? I know I am. Alright, well, I don't think there's anything fancy hidden on this. The only thing I see is that it looks like there's extra, like...
It was painted yellow and red.
Yeah, like, it looks like it was painted multiple times. Like, mm-hmm. There's this yellow... Like, it was painted to look like a dump truck or something?
Yeah, I imagine that was the other... Thing.
I'm just an intern, but I'm so excited I haven't slept in 2 days. Thank goodness for the sugar rush of waffle pops.
Wow.
Alright.
Want to start at the front and work back, or...
Yeah, how you want to do it? So, the movie's called Back to the Future. I know, back, but to the future? How is that even possible? So many dings. No joke, the title alone makes my brain fizz. I'd tell you more about what's going on here, but I haven't seen the script. They're keeping closer to their chest than spandex tank top. Oh, what I would give to read that thing. The producers love that suit of yours. Is it available for hire? Oh my god, Queen! I think my cache was fucked up because when I joined stream, it said Noita Part 50 in the title and it said you were playing Noita. That does happen if you're on browser. I know if you left a tab open, Twitch does that. That happens to Torny and me a lot because we both a lot of times leave tabs of like the streams we watch regularly open. And if it just resumes that tab and you don't like do a full actual refresh, then it gets all fucky. Twitch is real fucky. Queen GG on first. Weirdly, you clicked on it from another stream. Interesting. Boom!
Hit the
photo hut. pictures back in 1 hour.
Oh. Oh.
Boom, I'm on the photo hut.
Yeah.
I am the photo hut. Photo Hut Junior.
No.
116. I cut out. Yeah, that is unfortunately an issue with this game. For some reason, my mic cuts out when streaming this game specifically. Still no idea why. Still no way of being able to fix it. Yeah. And, like, the weird thing is it literally is OBS that has it cut out. So everything will be fine. But OBS just, like, stops recording the audio for a moment. Alright, time to do our preview, right? Or our post view. That was good.
Yeah.
Meow. Excellent.
Very nice.
All right. Time for the next mission.
Yep.
The Time Machine. Hello again. Meet our movie's star vehicle, the Time Machine. It's a car that's been modified by the genius inventor Doc Brown to incorporate a flux capacitor, fueled by bootleg plutonium, naturally. It reaches its top speed of 88 miles per hour in no time, so to speak. Anyway, riding those timelines is cold work, which has left it covered in temporal ice and astral particulate. Basically, our props department have had a field day with it, and we need to clean it for one last take. Oh, and we'd really appreciate it if you kept everything you've seen today under your hat, or mask. The future depends on it. Thanks a lot. One second. Okay, there we go.
Mess of wires and angles. Should we start the back and go forward? Front and go back?
What do you want to do? I want to spray the whole thing off. How incredible does this car look? Alright. I don't see any stuff under one layer. No idea what all the bits are, what they do. Something, something, something. like so many little pieces. What the hell? They just separately named every part. Yeah, they do that, but I feel like they went over the top with this mission. Yeah, Torny was just reminding me of there's a Final Fantasy DLC, and in that one there's like a level that has like a building that's like a miniature of a whole city, and that one also has like a ton of things. Jesus Christ.
Wait, come back, come back!
Oh, I think it's coming back. Uh-oh.
Holy sh-
Wow. Excellent. Well, we gotta put out the flames. You know, you don't want to leave a fire. That's a hazard. Does anybody see what's clean and what's dirty? No, there is. So there's a, there's actually two things. There's one button that just shows you, like, filth. And then you can also open up a menu to see what is clean and what's dirty. And if you open up the menu, you can tell it to make an area blink. Because, like, sometimes the dirt that's remaining is really hard to see.
Oh my god, it left the license plate.
Whoa!
Wow! It's a Chivo! Watch the time machine reappear!
Amazing!
Absolutely incredible.
GG Chivo.
Wow. Fucking cool.
Yeah, just, yeah, I'll show Queen in the next level. I'll show the how the different things work. Ooh, look at that. Look at that replay. Excellent. Hey, Power Wash Services! Any chance you're free to come down to the Universal Studios backlot? We're just wrapping up our film's incredible climax sequence, where the special effects team threw everything at our clock tower, even lightning! Now, the film's in the can, we need it meticulously cleaned down for the next production. You did a fantastic job on our vehicles, so naturally, you're the first person we thought of. Thanks a lot. I feel like you guys massively undercharge. It's true. We definitely are charging way less than I feel like Universal Studios should be paying us. Okay, so... closed door. Oh, interesting. Why can't I toggle that from all the way over here? We can toggle the door from all the way over here.
What?
fascinating. Anyway, so, so there's this button. This makes dirt highlight, like pulsate. Given your telekinetic powers, I think you're both undercharging and overworking. It's true.
Right.
Yes.
Interiors.
Yes. Begin the short. So, yeah, we have this button, which does that. And then, you can click a thing. Like, if we click that, or... okay, we'll click that. Now, entrance upper window will pulsate, like that. So that can help you find a part, and highlight the dirt on the part. Also, hello, Tony. Yeah, sure, we start up. Got the bell ringing achievo. For some reason, Torny does not get the option to do the interact. Ripperoni. Regular clue.
All right.
Dig the mystery machine vibes on the gun. Thank you. Yes. So. Yeah, there's a handful of, like, little skins you can unlock, and Torny is using the, like, gold one, and then, there's some sick anamorphosis art in this game. Would that be, like, subtraction art? Like, the leaving things kind of dirty slightly? Like, to make an image? Like, peeling away? The heck was that sound? Oh, that must have been you grabbing it. It's an image that is only viewable from the correct perspective. Oh!
Hang on.
Yes.
Maybe that's what it is. What? My prompts weren't showing up.
Ah, interesting. Yeah, you could definitely do some very good perspective stuff. I did not know that was the term for that. Thank you. Learn the term from a horror movie. Rah! Involves setting up kill scenes using Animorphs. That's fascinating. I'm slightly curious. I'm not a fan of horror movies, but that premise is fascinating. More of a psychological thriller. Psychological thriller, fine. I do like, so yeah, some psychological thrillers. Alright, this area looks good. So there's some stuff on this ledge, but I don't know if we want to try and stand on the thing over there and shoot up.
Let's do that.
Yeah. I know, I fell. Oh yeah, they do stop after that. The filth shadows. It's true. Walk over here. Oh, well, I guess Torny's getting them from one side, and I'm getting from the other, so we're mostly avoiding the filth shadows.
Some, though. We'll see them when we get back, or when we go down there.
Yep. Sure, we can go down. Boom. Ah, the two little behind this areas that escaped our vision. Standing one spot and cleaning only visible filth would qualify as anamorphous, because then it only looks clean from the spot when you clean it. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, definitely.
I've done that before, it's very silly.
Yes, there is. So, yeah, I can have either it points directly forward, or it has like a range. Pointing forward only is helpful for some areas, and it's very satisfying for, it's satisfying for some slow stuff that's kind of just nice for, like, visual stuff at the end. Like, there's one level that's like a skate park, and the whole ground is dirty, and it's really satisfying to do, like, a thing where you just point forward, and you just move in a perfectly straight line, and then move a little bit to the left, and then go down, and then, you know, left, and then up, etc., etc. Because at the end, you know, at the end of a mission, you get the little, like, slideshow thing, the stop motion of your cleaning. And so that looks really satisfying when you do stuff like that. Like, Torny and I have done some missions where we intentionally do them very slowly, but just to do really satisfying, like, end things. Apparently, in the first, like, couple of patches of this game, you did not have the ability to just do this. And in the first few patches, you did have to just move the whole camera. My understanding from listening to some people talk about this game once is that that was added, like, after, like, the game was out for a month or so. So, yeah, that... The first patches seemed like they would have been very rough. Yeah, it It really depends on where the camera is, too. But my guess is the camera will be, like, kind of head-on or something. Alright, no more stuff labeled entrance.
I don't believe so.
Alright.
Let's go.
Come on in to our abode. Tarny, hit the bell. Hit the bell. I've been belled. Alright, get in. Are you ready?
Come on, stand up, damn it. How do I stand?
I don't know. I just stood.
There
you go. LOL, get belled. You've been belled.
What?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure if you did that IRL, you would literally lose your hearing. Like, probably permanently. I do like that these gears are moving, like, properly. Like, these ones are moving, and this one is just moving this little thing. Well, mostly properly. I feel like this is not actually moving correctly. That's okay. Unless, are you saying between this gear and this gear, there should be something? Because I'm just thinking it's weird that, like, this, like, I'm pretty sure these are supposed to be connected in some way. It looks like they're supposed to be. The one that moves discreetly and the one that moves continuously. Oh, okay. So this would be the discreet one. I don't know what an escapement is. But that's okay. What the fuck is that crosshair? You don't like my crosshair? Kinda. The crosshair helps you visualize depending on how close you are. See? There's that. Or that. Alright, now we just need to find the entablatures. If I were an entablature, I would definitely be somewhere. The invention of the escapement allowed the invention of mechanical timekeeping. That's pretty good. Imagine if a real human ascended stairs like that. It'd be pretty good.
Hey!
Yeah, GG.
GG.
Just like, you just see someone running up and then backwards up the second flight. So which thing am I looking at? What is the escapement? Are you talking about that thing? Okay. So as this turns, that goes chunk, 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 chunk. So like it goes forward, but then it gets released. Yeah, so I assume, wow, let me be on the side of the one again. No. Rude. So I assume that basically, as the gear is rotating, it should be going at a steady interval. But then, you know, once it's moved that so much, then that falls to the other side type thing. And that back and forth motion is the thing that causes the other back and forth. Gotta brush your teeth. Yeah, let's get the There you go. That's better. I'm so used to playing Noita that I just pressed 1 to switch back to my other thing, and I didn't know it brought up that menu. I had no idea this menu was a thing. I like your cannon. That's a nice cannon. No, Queen. It's Schwartz. Are you ready?
I am.
Wonderful. Excellent. Let's hit the replay on that. Is it weird that I didn't know how much I liked clocks and how they worked until this conversation? No. I don't think that's weird. How do you ever figure out anything about yourself until it just happens, you know? I appreciate your knowledge on clocks, though. This has been fascinating to me. Queen, where are you when I'm starting a new Noi to run and I have like a 10-minute gap where I just don't have anything to do and I want just trivia? I need someone to just tell me about something. Next time this happens, I'm just gonna be like, all right, Queen, clock facts, boom. All right, next level. Do you remember how many levels were in this DLC?
It's 5.
So it was 3. Although the last two are probably gonna be big. Mm-hmm. So it was like, I wasn't sure if I wanted to split it. Cause that was the third, and I'm just like, do we want to save the last two for a separate thing? I don't know. Historically, the last like one or two have been pretty big on the other DLCs.
Yeah.
Where's that check?
Keep going if you want.
If you want to know them again, we'll see how we feel about the next one.
Yeah. What it is, and then
yeah. The Holomax Theater. Hey, Power Wash Services, how's it going? Hopefully you enjoyed your previous time with us and would like to come back for more Silver Screen Jet Wash action. We've got the green light for another two movies, which we're filming back to back. For these, we're time traveling all over the place, back to the Wild West of 1885, into the far-flung future of 2015, and even into the bleak alternative present, the present. It's a real mind-melter. Unfortunately, the first minds to be melted were those of the production crew. They started work on Hill Valley Town Square of the future, built this incredible-looking futuristic theater, but then trashed it, as if in the bleak alternate present. You know what? I'm getting the feeling that I'm in the danger of melting another mind here. So let's just say we've got a grubby, strange-looking movie theater, and we'd like you to wash down your inimitable and excellent fashion. Thanks a lot. The phone would give notifications for the stream prior to an hour for starts. That would be great. Yeah. Notifications are weird. So. Bottoms up.
Like, what would you prefer?
This actually does look like it might have writing on it.
Alright, so we'll go over it all with the white.
Yeah. Well, at least it looks like there's some posters or something. Yeah. Let's.
Well, then let's start.
Does that do anything? I suppose this is just random.
Yeah, it looks, I see like a bee. The same textures as the like railway station.
Maybe.
This one looks like a proper tag.
Yeah, what does that say? Something B O U I K Boik? Bovic? Interesting.
Well, should we get clean and proper, or do you want to keep hosing it down with the white?
Oh, we get clean and proper.
Alright.
So, you want to start at the top, or you want to start at the bottom?
Let's start at the bottom. Let's shake it up for once.
Alright.
Start at the bottom.
This is pretty satisfying. It is, it's true. The levels that are like large flat surfaces are just really nice to do this on. There's a handful in the base game. The base game is kind of split up between like a lot of large flat levels mostly, and then a lot of like vehicle levels that are like more intricate. And then the DLCs seem to try and combine those ideas a bunch. Butt spot is questionable. You are right. This is pretty sauce spreadsheet. I don't know. I think butt spot's true. It's pretty spreadsheet. That's kind of what my guess is. It definitely seems to do it at some sort of like it's not based on like the time. I've speculated that it's based on like a percentage that you've cleaned, or based on like you getting the dings or something. Yeah, it's normalized, but like you can go very slow. But it'll be the same like duration clip, like it, so it definitely seems to be based on like where you're taking the, like how much you've actually cleaned. Oh yeah, floor cleaned. All right. Shall we start going up slightly?
Yeah, let's do this inside area.
All right. Jaws 19, is that what that movie poster said? I'll have to go look at that again in a second. Oh my god, I see it right there. Jaws 19. Amazing. My favorite Jaws is sixth track on Light's fifth studio album, P.E.P.
we've done. This place is spotless.
Yeah, we can go home.
Yes. Well done.
Looking good. Look at that. Yeah.
All right, let's pack up.
Come here. Let me.
Oh my God.
I'll hit the button. Oh, I see some flashing from out here. Here, I'll get this. All right. Yeah, I think we're grime free.
Yep, I'm just getting these outside.
I see a little bit of grime. Oh my God, there's a whole ceiling out here. What year is this game supposed to take place in? Yorto! How are things in the Power Wash cinematic universe? They're going pretty well. The ancient aliens are not giving me too much trouble. You know what? I don't think they are. Currently, we are employed by Universal Studio to clean up stuff for this movie they're working on called Back to the Future.
We know the name sounds kind of silly. How can you go like...
Oh my God.
Wait, what?
A holographic... What the fuck just triggered that? Oh! Terrifying!
What did you do?
I think just standing over here triggers it. Yeah.
There's an X. You stand here.
Ah! Amazing. Yoto, how are you doing today? Have you... You finished D&D? No, we... D&D went well.
Look at...
Yeah, Mark likes to be clean.
Really, really personal. The shark is not real.
Speak for yourself. Thank you. Alright. Yeah, it looks good. But
we gotta get that hollow sign.
Oh, okay.
The hollow max sign.
They made so many Jaws movies. Oops, all Jaws. Isn't Back to the Future that new teardown expansion? It is! Excellent. Jaws had three sequels, and their combined gross revenue was less than half of the originals. I believe that. I just don't understand what the... I don't understand, like, a movie like Jaws. Like a sequel isn't interesting. Like, what are you doing in a sequel that just the first one just didn't already do? Like, that the whole... I don't know. It's just baffling. Like... Ooh! There's a smiley face. There's little feet prints that go to here. There was someone doing some parkour, I think. Ooh.
Bjorto, were you?
Yep, Bjorto came up here.
Oh,
yeah, it is a cool S. We got a cool S, E plus L. We got some other symbols. Are these alchemy symbols? Is this Noita?
Is this a Sampo?
Is this a Sampo? Oh my god. Maybe this is Sampo. Ed Dwarf Woot and Latorny Zhang. Yes. Yeah, I butchered that.
Okay.
We could draw a cool S all the time. We did not need to trace it. The fact that we haven't been doing that is maybe sinful. Something, some number sign. Yeah, the different angles take off different things better. Like light dirt comes off with some stuff. That's like a whole big thing in the main game. So, Queen, part of this is that because Torny and I have beat the base game, we unlocked, like, beating the base game basically allows you to unlock this tri-nozzle one. And this tri-nozzle one is incredibly overpowered. Like, when you're normally playing through the game, you're, like, trying to decide whether you want this really thin one that actually cuts through just about everything, or if you want to be using wider nozzles that, you know, don't
need more
caps. Yeah, they don't go through like paint as well and stuff like that. But since we beat the base game, we have the trident, and the trident just, you know, it's very powerful. There's also like a whole soap mechanic that we don't really need to worry about anymore. So, like, there's different types of soaps, and you can apply soaps, and soaps clean certain like, debris better. There's, like, glass cleaner, metal cleaner, plastic cleaner, multi-purpose cleaner. It's one of the things I actually think is a flaw with, like, the DLC and stuff. I think that they should have made you, like, they should have given you a kit of what they wanted you to have for them. Like, I don't think we should still just have this in the DLC. That being said, there are some mission levels that do take away, like, this and some other stuff. Yeah, like, I don't know, it just... There's no point in not using this when you have it, right? It's just too powerful. It is the secret Atlantean, nozzle. Oh no. My bean body fell down. Oh, is there not water on the ground here? Oh, the ground doesn't have water. I can't show off our bean bodies.
Here.
Hey, go get the door. We can show off our bean bodies. Look at that bean body. You can only see it briefly, but...
See it on my screen, but...
Yeah. Here. Spray me! The bean body. Okay. You bean, we bean. Artsy. Hello, Artsy. Ah, yes, the silhouette of the bean. Wonderful. Alright, I think we got just one big boy.
Alright, shall we start at either end and work in, you think, or...
Up to you.
Sure.
All right. Boom. Entry seal. Which one of these isn't done? Aha. Boom. And now theater roof trim.
We're both like, what the heck is the trim?
Alright, if I were a blinking something. It's not blinking. Oh! I see the blinking. Boom! Trigger, go trigger the shark. LOL, get sharked. Okay, can you trigger it one more time? I want to be in the shark. Big old freaky shark. Excellent. That's some good hologram technology they got. Queen. Oh my goodness. All right, are we ready? Are we ready for our stop motion?
Yep.
Very good.
Very satisfying.
Let's watch that again.
Yeah. See on the floor the zip 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 thing.
Very good. Doc's time train.
Oh boy, a train.
Hey pal, thanks for fitting us in again. We're wrapping up the third and final, and we do mean final, film now. And boy, is the scheduling getting tight. We went back to Wild West in this one, which naturally means we've got a time-traveling steam locomotive. How else is Doc gonna ride those timelines? I'm not really sure what happened, but the time train looks like it's been driven through a rainbow. Don't know if it has anything to do with some multicolored logs that we used in an earlier seen Old West train up to 88 miles per hour. Regardless, we need it for our next shot. I'll leave it to you. You know what you're doing, and thanks a lot. Yes, the power watch true. Might pause for a brief moment before we go into the next level. I kind of want to like get a snack or something. So
snacky.
Yeah. So we're gonna do short pause. So BRB. Okay. Redeemed, give Bert a treat. We can do that. Bertimus, would you like un treat?
So you've decided to join us, huh?
And who are you? Excuse me. Hello. Hi. There are no treats here for you. What? Give Zag a treat. Okay, well... He heard the redeem. Chomp, chomp, chomp. I get to try fancy. No, you don't get this treat. This is horchata cupcake that my stepmom made. Which I've not tried yet. She made them on Thanksgiving. Well, I think she made them before, the night before. And we brought them home. So I made a whole bunch of different things. I mean, it sounds super good. So, like, I'm very excited. Elaborate? I'm not sure what to elaborate on. They are supposed to be cupcakes that are made with horchata stuff. Like a lot of cinnamon and other things. I think both, Artsy. So definitely the cream, like, you cannot have the cupcake. Excuse me. Not for you. The cream is definitely, like, a very, very cinnamon. I can't even show it. Literally, if I try and show it in the camera, Zach's gonna try and eat it. Wow. That is good, though. That is super cinnamony and awesome. No. Okay. Can I show it on camera at all? Mr. Zaggy? It's like a really thick cinnamon cream. Nope. Take a picture with your phone, email it to yourself, and then screenshot the picture. All right, Torny is finishing a small slice of pumpkin pie, and then we will resume. It is homemade pumpkin pie, yes. So, Artsy, how are you doing today? Was it a good church day? Hopefully it was a good church day. Got to the 9 o'clock service at 9:40. Oof. Oof.
It's like Bert got up.
Zag's like, I get prime bed now. All right, it is time. It is time to start Jorb. Examine it. Oh, whoa. Little red tips. They're just perpetually opening and closing. Excellent.
Want to work our way?
Sure. I'm ready. I clean the flux capacitor.
Excellent.
You gotta have a clean flux capacitor?
Yeah.
Is that what you're gonna say? Yeah.
Section,
I
guess? This front bit?
I forgot, what's the front of a train called? The front of the engine.
I believe this is the
engine. Yeah. The cow catcher. Oh, okay. Yes. The front of the train is the cow catcher. Thank you, Bjorka. My dad professionally works on trains. I'll have to tell him the next time that I finally can remember that the front of the train is the cow catcher. Kind of trains. I know it's like
freight,
yeah. Cause like he works on some that carry chemicals up and down the East Coast. But like I don't remember what company he works on the East Coast. But yeah, I don't remember the company specifically that he works for, but yeah, he is a he's an engineer. So yeah, I know he does like a lot of he's done a few jobs for him. Like he's done the not like the macro logistics, but like some of the like more day-to-day logistics, like planning some of the routes and to make sure like things don't collide, where they have to, like, kind of share tracks and stuff. I don't know, does a lot of things that I don't fully know the details of. At one point, I knew more of what he was doing, but it has, like, what he's done has changed over the years, too. But a lot of, like, him working for trains happened after I stopped living on the East Coast, so. He played mini Metro but macro. it.
The back side.
Yeah. And then see all this wheel crud. There's so much wheel crud.
Did you get the wheels
on
my side?
I didn't get the wheels on your side, no.
Wait, just...
Did you get the wheels on your side?
Oliver?
Yeah, I didn't get the wheels on your side. Alright, that's looking good.
Alright, move on to the cab thingy.
Yeah. I really wish that this game had, like, a really weird, bizarre parkour section or something, because it's got very bizarre physics that interact with your bean body, and, like, you just do this weird slide, really high jump off slopes that I just think would be really fun to have a parkour course with. What if the next Power Wash DLC was a crossover with Mirror's Edge? Power Wash Mirror's Edge. You have to go Power Wash giant, like, skyscrapers. That would be so good. It would never happen, but I love the idea of it. Jet Set Radio isn't far off.
Except you're... yes.
Is Jet Set Radio the old one or the new one? Like, I know that there's a game that came out recently that is like a callback to an old game, and I don't remember which one is which. Bomb Rush Cyberpunk is the new one. Okay. Same but different name. It is. They did a very good job making a name that feels like the other name. This is the cab buffer, but I misread it as crab buffer.
Crab.
I do love crab. Pressing this button just toggles whether or not my sprayers are going, like, look at this. It's because the button I'm toggling is whether or not I have control over it. Yeah, the camera lock, but it's very funny to me that it's making the sprayers do that. Gotta keep your loop knife clean. Loop knife? What the heck is a loop knife? Is this a loop knife?
Those sharp thingies on the front, apparently.
Oh, reactor car time loop knife. Interesting. I mean, yeah, you would not want your loop knife to be dirty. That's true. Well, yeah. Temporal contamination is just all right out. That's definitely not allowed. Hello, Kerr. Thank you for the reminder to hydrate. How are you doing today? Not looking forward to Monday. Oh no. Why is that? Is that just because you have to like go back to a work thing? Or a kid's thing? Also, are you feeling better today? Are you starting to feel back to normal, or still slowly one day at a time kind of thing? Mostly kids back to school and the generic grind return. Makes sense. Power washing's been going good. We're on the last level of this DLC, which... That'll put the DLC taking about 2 hours to complete, because we're almost done with this. And I gotta say, I do think that this was a little underwhelming compared to the other DLCs. I think both of the other ones we did in 2 streams, right? Yeah.
I mean, we probably could have done this in 2 streams, but we decided to break it up.
But if we broke it up, it would have been only an hour stream each. The other ones each took 4 hours, I think, or 3. Like, this one was significantly smaller. None of them were a big mission. Whereas, all of the other DLCs have had at least one level that was very big. Like, the SpongeBob one, most of them were kind of small, but the final one was actually very large. The final one we did is, like, an entire single stream, I think. I don't know. If this is the last level, which I believe it is, then there was no big levels in this, and that's a little underwhelming, considering the fact I'm pretty sure this was a paid DLC, not a free DLC.
Yeah, this one
and
was paid.
It was like $7. So like, you know. And again, like part of there's gonna be some mindset related things. Like honestly, a lot of things are undercharged, especially in game related stuff. Especially indie games. A lot of indie games which do not sell if they're over certain price points, despite the fact that those price points are probably the actual, like, reasonable price points for them. That's a whole thing with games. But that being said, like, $7 for a DLC that's, I don't know, pretty small levels and about 2 hours seems like $5 would have been nicer. But that's okay. It's not a big deal. Pretty better stuffed sinus and coughing. I assume that means you still have some stuffed sinuses and coughing. That's where our Lord and Savior, Pseudoephedrine, comes into play. Dear Pseudoephedrine, who I pray to every day, allow us to breathe and not have the annoying stuffy nose effect. Zeldikins, hello! Thank you for reminding me to hydrate. We are going to be nice and wet with our power washer. We're having a good wet time. Zeldikins, oh my gosh, you've redeemed the treat ritual. You are going to have to wait a little bit. It is currently... technically their food has not gone off yet, but their food goes off in, like... 3 or 4 minutes, and they will not leave the food area knowing that it's going to be that close. Like, the little food thing that tells them that their other food thing's going to go off soon has gone off. and they will not leave the food area until the real food comes out once that goes off. Also, if I'm cutting out, I'm sorry. Power wash makes my microphone randomly cut out, and for OBS exclusively. And I don't have a way of fixing that, and I don't know when it cuts out. So, I apologize in advance. Real lifting is extra hard. Yeah, it is a stimulant, that is true. That being said, I've never looked into it in depth, but I've never heard of anything saying you cannot take pseudoephedrine if you've taken other stimulant medications. But I mean, it would be something to be aware of, and like, you know, obviously things are going to differ person to person. If there's ever a concern of anything with your heart, that's a big no-no. You also don't usually want to take Sudafed, you know, or similarly other stimulants too late in the evening. That is specifically why I almost exclusively have tons of the 4-hour dosing Sudafed, because
all the stuff's reactor car.
Then I can, like, take it later in the day. Reactor car? Which one's the reactor car? Booty.
There's stuff on this one, but I cannot figure out where. It says there's something on it.
I'll find it. Whoa. Right? I mean, we gotta wait. Vehicle. I know. It's very rude. Sudafedrin, similar to Ritalin, but you take Vyvanse, and those two meds work in opposite ways. Yes, I personally am not super knowledgeable about the actual, like, mechanism. Practice. Literal pharmacy.
the impression.
I suppose we can watch the replay. We can give up. It might not come back. You ready for that replay? All right. Boom. Uh-oh, I broke it. There we go. Very good. Let's hit that with the second time. Boom. Excellent. That was very good. Alright. Continue. Boom. Yep, that was it.
That's all.
So yeah. 2 minutes. We started after like 5 minutes or so. So yeah, about a little over 2 hours for the whole thing. Which, you know, two hours is a fine amount of time for a DLC. But like $7 is just... very TLDR. Both work upon the concept of normalizing the stimulus on your brain to enable the task switching. Ritalin works by dulling things, and amphetamines work by exciting things. And goal stimulus around you should be fairly even, so they make more conscious choice in what you choose to focus on, instead of being at the mercy of anything around you. Being overtired, hungry, or whatever, taking too much is why you hear people. Yes, no, that. So that's a whole thing. There's a whole thing about dosing amounts. Like, a lot of people don't understand that with it not just with ADHD meds, but with a lot of medications, if you're at an appropriate dosage amount, you shouldn't really like notice that much. Like, because there's not an unusual feeling going on. Like, I don't know. You should feel more just normal. Like, I'm on chronic pain medications, and if I'm taking the appropriate amount of medication for the amount of pain I'm on, then, like, it mostly just lets me function as a normal person. There's no, like, other thing going on. So,
Did you want to switch to Noida, or did you want to call?
Well, I'll probably wrap up. I want to do cat treats, but they haven't come back yet. But they should have finished their food. They should be. I mean, their food should have gone off like a few minutes ago. Yes, but it's very obvious to people when they are not in their midst. I mean, exactly, Artsy. Yes, that is correct. So maybe there was ambiguity or poorly phrasing in what I was saying. I wasn't saying you should not notice that you've taken your meds. You should not have a large feeling like side effect, like the zombie feeling and stuff. Like, that is taking too much. This is a thing that comes up a lot, again, if you work in pharmacy and people talk about things like a lot of people don't realize that they're taking too much of a medication. They're like, oh, this medication makes me feel this way. And it's like, yeah, you need to talk to your prescriber. That it probably means you're taking too much. Like, a really big thing that happens is that prescribers don't seem to go over with patients a lot of times that you should start on small amounts of things and then see, like, Like, don't start at a higher dose of something. Start at a smaller dose of something and then see the amount that actually, like, works for you. That also happens because less is not functional. Yeah, like, again, start small and then you increase, like, each time you find out the amount that actually seems to work. Like, you don't want to overdo it. And a lot of people, and I'm using the word a lot here, I'm not saying a majority of people, but I'm saying there's, like, a... It is not uncommon to see people who are taking too much of medications and don't realize that that's what's happening. Like, they literally do not know because essentially, like, it could be for a lot of reasons, but essentially they do not realize that you should start smaller on things. Like, not just jump into big things. I think part of it is probably, like, you know, this is pure speculation, but... you know, if you're, like, excited about something, you know, like, something's supposed to help, so you're like, ah, yes, I'll take more of this, you know? Like it happens with people with pain medications, too. Like, if you're in a lot of pain, you're like, ah, I need the most of the pain medication. That's not actually a good thing, you know? It's like, this is gonna sound silly, but, you know, it's like when you're hungry and you're like, oh, I need a giant food, but... You probably don't actually need a giant food. You just think you need a giant food, but then you overeat. Same kind of thing kind of happens. And then again, you sometimes have people that, like, they do take a lower dose of something, and they think because the lower dose didn't have an effect, like, to drastically increase the dose, when really you might need just a little bit more. And sometimes people just don't give things enough time. There's a lot of medications that you have to be on for literally like 2 or 3 weeks at a single dose before you'll know that it's having a consistent effect. Like, and humans are just not patient. like, needing to be on something for 2 weeks to see if there's an effect is hard for people to perceive. And on top of that, if you're not doing something like some sort of health charting, like... You may not even be aware of the differences that have happened because you're just not aware of how you were 2 weeks ago. Like, that's not going to be everyone, but that is a lot of people. Humans are bad at, like, self-realization, especially over long periods of time. For your friends that finally accept this is a thing and finally get a script after all the testing work... They don't want to wait longer to get treated. Yeah, exactly. Like, yeah, health journaling is a really big thing. I think a lot of people don't want to do it, but even just journaling, like, some general thoughts on how you're feeling or how you were feeling throughout the day, and then being able to compare that to, like, a week ago, be like, hey, you know what? I have been making improvements even if I didn't really feel like it. Like, that's very, very helpful. What's really helpful is looking at stuff over the course of, like, a month, but, you know. That also comes up a lot with with depression-related medications, because almost all depression-related medications take, like, 3 weeks to kind of kick in. And if you are feeling less depressive states... Like, if you're having depressive states, like, you know, once a week compared to, like, every day, or even if it's once a day for an hour compared to literally the entire day every day, like, that's a huge difference, but you may not even be fully aware of that if you're not documenting it in some way. Yeah, I think my dad definitely feels like putting on glasses these days. I don't really understand journaling that well. I don't know if it's because I have an inner monologue, but it's hard to write down my thoughts. Likely overthink it. Yeah, Kerr is exactly right. Like, in all honesty, you really don't need to think it through. Just, bullet points are a big thing. Yeah, how bullet journal, like, Yeah, like, Torny does health charts, but just, like, some things, like, some big things, it's just notable things. Like, you know, like, just a really simple statement of, like, you know, had a hour today was feeling depressed. Like, something that's notable about stuff. Anything you can...
Or even if, like, when I'm having mood swings, I just say moods up and down. It doesn't have to be specific.
Yeah. But something that'll, you know, something that, like, kind of is an indicator. It doesn't matter. It's not something you're turning in to be graded. Like, it's literally whatever you feel like looking at. But the point is, like, you know, if you can look at something, if you've changed something about your life, like, maybe you are trying to eat better or something, or you're starting a new med, or adjusting a dosage of a medication, like, anything. If you can look from the point you know that you changed that, you know, mark that. When something changes, you mark that in the journal. But if you can look at that point, and then you can look at, like, a week later, and then 2 weeks later, and just look at a few entries, and be like, hey, you know, is there a consistent change or not? And if there is a change that's, you know, that's interesting, again, like, there's a whole thing where, you know, that might not be 100% just A, you know, affected B, but there's definitely some correlation you could look at. And a lot of times they, you know, it's a very good thing to kind of be in a habit for. Yeah, putting like one drink, like a D1 or D3 for how many drinks. Yeah. All right. So, it should be enough time. Oh, boy bees. Are there any boy bees? Well, hello, a boy bee. Hello. What are you doing? Why are you right there? Go into bed. Into bed. Yes. Are we gonna get a second boy bee? Oh my god, we have a second boy bee. You also get into bed. Get into bed. Get into bed. You know the rules of getting treats. Zag, you can have that treat. Oh. And now, Bert gets one. No, hold on, Zaggo, over there. No, 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 Zaggo. You can't block my arm to Bert. That's cheating. That is cheating. That's cheating. That's cheating. You can't be right there. No. Go back into your bed. Aha. Ha ha! Bert got it. Oh my gosh, artsy with the Zaggo treat. Zaggo. Is there a Zaggo? Well, chomp chomps. Chomp 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 chomp. He's like, yes. Oliver, I'm sorry. There's not another treat for you. There was only another one for... Oh! Just kidding. All right, excellent. We've done some treat-o time. Alright, I'm going to wrap up for the evening. I might actually go to bed early tonight. Anyway, I'm gonna go over to Colette, who... I don't know what Colette's doing. I think Colette's on break right now. That's the best time to raid. Yeah, looks like Colette is on break doing some words on stream. So, we're gonna go over there. I don't know if that means she's planning on switching to Stardew. I know she was doing Hollow Knight, Pantheon 5 stuff. I don't know if her plan was to keep doing that, or to switch, or what. But I'm going to go and wrap up. And I do think I'm gonna go to bed. I'm really tired today. So, I think I might go to sleep. Anyway, tomorrow we will return to Noita, I think. Part of me, after playing the Teardown DLC, part of me was thinking about looking to see what new mods have come out and maybe doing another Teardown mod stream. But I might do that on one of my days off and do another like early day stream and then like an evening one. So we'll see. Anyway, have a good evening. Thanks for hanging out.